Hey guys, Jannik here for Cinecom.net and welcome back to another Copycat Friday. And in this week's tutorial, we are going to recreate an effect from our favorite Instagram VFX artist.
Hey guys, Cash Bunny here. Super excited to watch Cinecom's remake of my nesting dance video.
You are seeing this right. This video will be a small collaboration for the cool nesting dance effect she did with Will Smith and Jason Derulo. And sadly, no, Will Smith won't be in this video. But this is how it's going to work. First, we will explain how we recreated it in After Effects. And when we are done, Cash Bunny will rate our effect and tell us if we were right or wrong. Heck, she will even give some pointers and show us some BTS on how she did it. So stick by us until the end, guys. But now, let's start shooting. First, we need footage. And for this, we are going to use a 360 camera. More specific, the Insta360 ONE X. Now it's quite mandatory to do this effect with a 360 camera because this way you will have ultimate freedom when tilting and panning in post-production. So okay, let's shoot. Mount your 360 camera on a C-stand or a light stand, or you can stand on whatever you want and hold it with a stick. It's your choice. Once done, we will start filming with a top shot. Your dancer can dance almost underneath the camera. Then let another dancer come in, push the old one out of the shot, and the new dancer will then pretend to lower the camera until eye height. What we did was use the first dancer to lower our C-stand together with the acting of our second dancer, if that makes sense. Then when the camera is on eye height, let your second dancer dance and move out of the frame after a few seconds. Then, very important, super very duper important, don't touch your camera and make a clean plate. And make it long enough, around 30 seconds will be enough. Okay, next up will be another dancing clip of our first dancer. However, we first raise the camera a little bit so that we create a light top shot of our dancer. Let your dancer dance and move out of the frame. Then last, again raise the camera a little bit and let your other dancer do its thing. And these are the shots you need for this effect. Let me summarize. Shot number one is a very high top shot of a dancer that swings into an eye level shot of a second dancer. Then the second shot is a very light top shot of dancer number one. And the last shot is a medium top shot of dancer number two. And that's it. Now before we can do the post-production, we first need two things. The free GoPro Reframe plugin, which you will find the link to in the description below. And the beta version of After Effects, which is also free for every Adobe user and can be found under this tab in the Creative Cloud app. Now we are using the beta version of After Effects for the new and improved rotoscoping tool. If you want to learn more about it, check out our video, you'll find a link in the description below. Okay, let's jump into After Effects, or into our sponsor Storyblocks video, which is an online stock video library that keeps on expanding. They have a ton of stock clips about really everything, from animals to beautiful nature to awesome aerial shots. I tell you, they have everything. They even have a buttload of VR and 360 footage you can use. So if you are planning a 360 video or game, Storyblocks Video has your back. Especially with their easy to customize After Effects templates, which will save you so much precious time. And the best thing about Storyblocks Video is the fact that you only have to pay one single price per year for unlimited downloads. So stop wasting time and get yourself Storyblocks Video with the first link in the description below. Okay, we have our three shots in After Effects. First, let's place the high top shot into our timeline. This is going to be the base of all and also holds our empty shot. But with this shot, we are also going to create a loop, which will become clear later on. So your shot is in the timeline and the first thing you can do is place the GoPro Reframe effect on it. Then set the project option of the effect to GoPro 4K 69 or HD, it's what you want. And next, use the pan, tilt and rotate to align the clip towards your dancer. Now we will make it loop ready. So look for the point where your dancer is in a close-up. Here we are going to make a cut and this will be the start of our effect. But don't remove the clip left of the cut. We are going to use it later on. Just place it at the end of your timeline. Next, we are going to adjust our pan, tilt and rotate options until we have the framing that we want. Now enable the animation for the tilt option of the GoPro Reframe effect. Then go further in time to around 15 seconds and here you can decrease the tilt value. This way your camera will point to the floor And look at that, we already have a tilting camera motion. Now let's start with our dancers. Our first dancer is Lorenzo and we need to separate him so that we can place stuff behind him. That's why we have to duplicate our main clip and trim it so that we only have Lorenzo dancing. This will leave you with a short second clip. Now select that clip, right click on it and pre-comp it. Of course, select the option move all attributes to a new composition and also select this very important option adjust the duration. This will make sure that the length of the pre-comp clip remains the same as the original clip. Now on this new composition we are going to rotoscope our dancer. So select the rotoscoping tool and with the tool selected double click on your dancer clip. This will open up the layer tab where we can start our rotoscoping. But first, change some settings. Set the quality to best and the contrast to 10. Now with the rotoscope brush make strokes over your dancer to select him. If you select it too much you can hold Alt to make removing brush strokes. Once you are done and selected the dancer, just hit the space bar and let After Effects render it all. And normally Roto Brush is super good, so adjusting it will be minimal. Then when it's done, stop your playback and hit the freeze button. This will lock our rotoscope information and will make sure that we don't need to render it again. Look at that, we have Lorenzo on a separate layer. And this means we can place everything we want behind him. Or just a clip of me dancing. Now with that clip of me dancing, we are going to do the exact same thing as before. First we place it underneath Lorenzo and more towards the end. Then add the GoPro reframe effect and make your framing. Again enable the animations for the tilt option and tilt a little bit downwards from the beginning to the end. Then of course pre-comp the layer and now we can rotoscope me. Select the rotoscope tool and double click on the Janik dancing clip. Again do all the rotoscope thingies and freeze the result. If you have done this correctly, you will now have two nesting dancers. However, we're not finished yet. Again do all the same steps with the last clip of Lorenzo dancing. And this will leave you with three nesting dancers. And now, it's time to add the final dancers and create the loop. Still remember that clip we placed at the end of the timeline and the beginning of the video? Well, take that clip and lay it underneath the last Lorenzo clip. Now with the GoPro reframe effect, we are going to zoom out a little bit to hide our dancing Janik behind the dancing Lorenzo. Then enable the animation for the zoom and the X and Y offset options. Next, go further in time until Lorenzo moves away. And on this moment, we are going to zoom the Janik clip back in and position it on the spot we want. Then go even further in time and look for the point where Lorenzo wants to grab the camera. Here you can reset the zoom option back to 100 and both the offset options to 0. Also, on this very moment, you can enable the animation for the tilt option and then go to the end of the clip. Because on the end of the clip, the tilt needs to have the exact same value as the tilt from the first clip. So copy that value and paste it at the end. Now the next problem that we have is the floor of the empty shot don't match with the floor of the end shot. But we can fix that by removing the floor of the end shot. So pre-comp our end layer, then make a duplicate and trim that duplicate so that you only have dancing Janik. Of course, you can already guess it. We are going to rotoscope me out. Now on the original last layer, we are going to rotoscope Lorenzo out. This way we have both dancers separate and standing on the empty shot. Oh yeah, a good tip. If you are missing shadows, just duplicate the clip you want shadows for, then remove the rotoscope and use a feathered mask around the feet. Of course, animate the mask to follow the feet. And boom, you have shadows. Then the only thing we need to do is animate the empty shot back to the begin values. So copy the keyframes from the beginning and paste them at the end. One last thing, copy the keyframes located on the 15 second mark and paste them on the moment Lorenzo reaches for the camera. Otherwise the tilting back to normal would start too early and would give something strange. And now you normally have a loop. But we also have a lot of mistakes on the sides. However, this is easily fixed by making the video a vertical video just like Cash Bunny has. This will crop every mistake that is happening on the sides and will leave you with a perfect looping nesting dance ready to take over your social media.
So first of all guys, great job. You really, really nailed the effect and it looks amazing. So good job. Now, one of the first things I noticed that was a difference in how we both shot was that I used a tripod with a 10-foot pole attached to it, and you guys had this C-stand contraption with the extra arm hanging out, which is 1,000 times better because so many hours of my edit were spent just removing that tripod. It's a really, really big task. So you guys completely like did away with that and just made this very, very simple solution to a problem that doesn't even need to exist. So great job with that. And if I shoot another one of these, I'm definitely gonna steal your method. So the next thing that we approach differently is just the method of cutting out those middle two positions. So basically position 2 and 3 are never actually on a practical background. They're just completely cut out. So you can totally shoot on green screen, and that's what I chose to do just to make my life a little bit easier and to get really, really clean cutouts. Made sure that the green screen went all the way to the ground so that I could get the feet clean. Something to keep in mind if you are choosing to use a green screen is that you're gonna have to start with position 2 and 3. So just make sure you know how high your camera's gonna be at each position so you don't accidentally do the same height for position 1 and 2, or else you won't really get that perspective change. So one detail that always makes a big difference and takes a VFX video to the next level is adding really convincing shadows. And so I did that in my video by just adding like a very simple shadow catcher and just basic 3D little light to sort of match where the light source was in the actual video, and just like added like a very, very heavily diffused low opacity shadow just so it kind of looked like there was a little bit of interaction from the cutouts with the environment. The fact that you guys shot without very harsh lighting is a huge advantage to making this look believable, and I think it would just be like a very, very small detail that could bring it to the next level. So another thing that I didn't really anticipate would be so difficult about this edit is just sort of positioning the rotoscoped dancers to look like they're actually standing in the space, because, you know, if you position the head where it should be to be a little bit shorter than the person before, then the feet will kind of look like they're overlapping. So, you know, you can kind of like keep shimmying it back and forth and try to make it look perfect. You can try to scale it a little bit. Which I tried all of that and none of it really looked perfectly convincing. And so my solve for that was just to zoom it in a little bit more so you couldn't see the feet in most of the shots. And that ended up working really well. And I see you guys did the same solve here. So really good job on that. I'm kind of curious if you guys ran into the same issues I did. And so here we don't see feet, we don't see feet. We don't see feet until the very end of this shot. And then, I mean, right there you can see, if we go back, you can see how the feet do overlap for a quick second right there. And that back foot, or the foot of the back dancer, is actually kind of overlapping the front one. So it's not something that you can necessarily solve perfectly, I don't think, except if you want to like completely zoom in, which isn't always the best way. So that could be solved with like some time remapping, maybe making the previous dancer sort of go out a little bit quicker so that you don't see the feet overlap. But yeah, like you guys solved it the same way I did, and I think it works, and I think most people, 99% of people who aren't looking super, super critically are not gonna notice that. So I think it's totally fine and works really well actually. I love your dance moves, by the way. I don't know if I mentioned that yet.
Thank you so much, Cash Bunny, for those awesome insights of your brain. Your work keeps on amazing me. So guys, check out our Instagram. You'll find the link in the description below. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Storyblocks Video, for the support. And like always, stay creative. Hallo jongetjes, het is meneer Jannik. Hallo, we gaan copycat vandaag doen, ja? Ja, gaan we copycat doen? Ja, we gaan copycat doen, ja. Fuck, het is zo warm.